Since our concern in this course is with operating systems, I'm going to leave you to explore most of the physical layer on your own and focus on the part that has implications for the operating system at the edge of the network and end users like you and me. The most important piece of hardware for us, then, is the network interface card, or NIC. This typically is a direct memory access, or DMA, device, meaning that once connected to the memory bus, it has the ability to read and write from memory on its own, independent of the CPU. Typically, the CPU specifies through the bus the range of memory it wants to be sent, whether it's a read or write, and then sets the go bit to let the NIC begin. The NIC then tries to copy the data as requested. Because the NIC controller puts all of the copy instructions on the bus, the CPU doesn't have to. He can go about his business. To the extent that he finds the information he needs in the CPU cache, there won't be any contention on the memory bus. Only when the NIC finishes either sending or receiving a packet need he bother the CPU with an interrupt. The NIC controller is also responsible for putting hardware-specific headers and footers on the data. For physical Ethernet, this would include an interframe gap of silence and a special preamble to indicate the start of a frame.